Hello students, I myself Nitesh Kumar, Electronics Engineering Department. Continuing with my earlier e-lectures, today we will focus on multiple access techniques and in that especially CDMA. This is basically for electronics instrumentation EIC students 8th semester, wireless communication. Now in the previous lectures we have studied about these multiple access techniques, duplexing, FDD, TDD, TDMA, FDMA. Now basically in introduction to multiple access, FDMA, TDMA and CDMA are the three major access techniques used to share the available bandwidth in a wireless communication system. These techniques can be grouped as earlier discussed, as narrow band and wide band, depending upon the available bandwidth allocated to the user. Right? Now let's start our CDMA, code division multiple access technique. What is its advantages over the two, that is FDMA, CDMA, FDMA and TDMA, we will also discuss here. What is its advantages, its architecture, its performance, we will elaborately deal in CDMA. Now in CDMA, the narrow band message signal is multiplied, as you can see here, is multiplied by a large bandwidth signal, also called as spreading signal, and it is done before modulation and transmission over the air. CDMA is also called as direct sequence spread spectrum. This DSS is a more general term. CDMA is a particular and DSS is a more particular term. Now in CDMA, we multiply a narrow band message signal by a large bandwidth signal, and as earlier you can see, this is earlier discussed FDMA, where frequency slots are divided, in TDMA time slots are divided, and in CDMA neither the frequency nor the time, it is the code which is unique for every user. You can easily see that this is the code which is unique for every user, as it is shown in the colored way, blue, this green, orange and yellow. This represents each different users, but here you can see that every user have a different code, but it can transmit at any time and for complete frequency range, unlike the TDMA and FDMA. So in CDMA, the narrow band signal is multiplied by a large bandwidth signal, also called as spreading signal, that is also termed as code. Now question arises, what is the spreading signal? Now this spreading signal is consists of chips. It is a PN sequence, a pseudo random sequence. The narrow band signal is multiplied by a very large bandwidth signal called the spreading signal. The spreading signal is a pseudo noise code sequence that has a chip rate which is orders of magnitude greater than the data rate of the message. An important point here is the chip rate is greater than the data rate of the message. Now PN sequence is called a code word. Each user has its own code word. Code words are orthogonal, that is they have low autocorrelation among themselves. Spreading signal uses a PN sequence, a pseudo random sequence. PN sequence are randomly generated 1010 bits, which are sequentially generated such that each user have a different code and each user has its own code word, and it has to be provided at the receiver end so that it can be easily decoded also. And these code words which are generated by the PN sequence in the form of 1010 bits, they are orthogonal. The receiver correlator distinguishes the sender signal by examining the wideband signal with the same time synchronized spreading code. The sent signal is recovered by despreading process at the receiver. It means at the transmitting side, we have to generate a PN sequence, that is the bits of 1010, and the same bit have to be at the receiver side so that it can be decoded that for which user this code belongs to this code. Now in CDMA, each user is assigned a unique code sequence. The receiver, knowing the code sequence of the user, decodes the received signal and recovers the original data. The bandwidth of the coded data signal is chosen to be much larger than the bandwidth of the original data signal. That is the chip rate, which I have already communicated to you. That is the main point. And CDMA is based on spread spectrum modulation. If multiple users transmit spread spectrum signal at the same time, the receiver will still be able to distinguish between users, provided that each user has a unique code that has a sufficiently low cross correlation with other codes. Now CDMA schemes are, it can be broadly classified as direct sequence CDMA, frequency hopping CDMA, and time hopping CDMA. Here we will see direct sequence CDMA. Why it is known as also broadly classified as direct sequence spread spectrum sequences also we will see. So basic is this, in CDMA each user is assigned a unique code, and that code is generated is in the form of 1010 bit PN sequence as shown here. Each user has its own code word. Code words are orthogonal. That have to be at the receiver side. The sent signal is recovered. How? By despreading the process at the receiver. Now, its advantages. Before starting its advantages, the points which we have to consider is that the receiver performs a time correlation operation to detect only the specified desired code word. All other code words appeared as noise due to decorrelation. For detection of the message signal, the receiver needs to know the code word used by the transmitter. That is the main limiting factor here. Or you can say, if the receiver knows the code word without any problem, it can easily detect that each user operates independently with no knowledge of the other user. Now, as you all have the information of FDMA and TDMA, so the best part of CDMA is that it have the complete range of frequencies and time slot available for all the users to send its signal. That is the beauty of this CDMA. Thank you.